I once upon a time used to say to myself, Alhamdulillah, the people have understood Tawheed and the people have understood the Sunnah. Allahumma barik. But when I saw how Hatim al-Auni could just play around with people's for whom of La ilaha illallah, what it means. And ibadah, and people can literally quickly just move like that. I realized the works of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab have to be taught so often and so continuously. It's amazing. Wallahi, what that book can do. So walidhalika, the biggest enemy they have is Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. They hate him so much. Wallahi, they do. And it's not him personally. And I'm going to do a silsila on Shaykh Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, inshallah. I'm trying to bring out. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab had something different to any imam that came before him. Hatta Ahmed Muhammad didn't have. Hatta Aimatul Arba'ah didn't have. Wala Ibn Taymiyyah hatta didn't have. And that was, he could say something and make sure it happens. Ibn Taymiyyah was saying things and he couldn't make it happen. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, why they hate him is because he brought concepts in and he made sure it took place. He made sure those idols were destroyed and those graves were destroyed. It's different now. So when you hear, and it's happening now, they're trying to distinguish between Ibn Taymiyyah's path and Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab's path. And they say they're two different people. The difference is only Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab made sure it happened. That's really the difference, and nothing else. Theoretically, both of them are the same. And only why Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab could make sure that he executed and made sure it happened was because that's a government and a leader behind him that can make it happen.